डॉक्टर भास्कर असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग अन्ना यूनिवर्सिटी चेन्नई. एरिया ऑफ स्पेशलाइजेशन इज सॉफ्टवेयर इंजीनियरिंग एंड डेटाबेस सिस्टम. गाइडेड मोर देन 12 रिसर्च स्कॉलर्स, पब्लिश्ड मोर देन 40 नेशनल एंड इंटरनेशनल पेपर्स. इज अ रिव्यूअर एंड एडिटोरियल बोर्ड मेंबर इन इंटरनेशनल जर्नल्स.
वेलकम टू यूजीसी लेक्चर कंटेंट सीरीज ऑन कंप्यूटर साइंस. इन दिस we are going to look at software engineering, which is one of the hot field in computer science engineering. In this particular session, we'll be looking at the contents like software myths. What are the various myths that is commonly said in software engineering? Then we'll look on the definition of what a software engineering is, software process, different characteristics of software, applications of software, various terminologies used in software, and roles of management in the development of software. First, we'll look at the different software myths. People quite often say software is easy to change. So people presume that the programs that is written is called as a software. So programs are often quite easily changeable. So it is not only the programs, it is the documentation which is to be changed. It starts out with the analysis. So we need to change from the basic requirements, go for analysis, go for design, then comes the program. So if you want to change the program, that is not the change that has happened in software engineering. So it has to be changed on the entire flow. So that is one of the main myth which people do have. The second myth is, computers provide greater reliability than the devices they replace. So generally talking about computers, they provide greater reliability, but people don't rely on the software that is being used. Third one is testing software. Reusing software increases safety. The fifth myth is software can work right the first time. Say, once I have developed the software, I cannot be very much satisfactory on the type of work which I have done. So I need to get in consultation with the customers. I need to get their concurrence. Then I'll give it for delivery. Software can be designated thoroughly enough to avoid most integration. So on designing the entire software, I'll be doing unit level, integration level, system level, and acceptance level. So as the unit level, with individual developers, I'll be testing on it. Then I'll go for integration, where if I'm having a clear cut idea on the design, then I'll go for integration. Software with more features is better software. Addition of more software engineering will make up the delay. Aim is to develop working programs. So those are some of the myths people generally have on software. Now let's look at the definition, which is a literal definition of when I say the term software. Process of manufacturing the software systems. This is a literal definition given for software. So it's like normal manufacturing which people do. But coming on to the technical definition of software, Fritz Bayer has defined software engineering to be the establishment and use of sound engineering principles in order to obtain economically developed software that is reliable and works efficiently on real machines. Here we have three different keywords. The first keyword is sound engineering principles. The second keyword is economically developed software that works efficient, which is the third keyword. When you look at the first keyword, we require some principles to be coined while developing the software. So we need to say what are those principles when we develop software as such. The second definition is being given by Stephen Shaw, who has defined software engineering to be as a discipline whose aim is the production of quality software, software that is delivered on time, within budget, and that satisfies its requirements. So here we have four different keywords. The first keyword is quality software. The product which is delivered to you should be of utmost quality, and it should have been developed on time and within the cost and satisfies all the requirements which is posted by your clients and as such. So these are the two different definitions, technical definitions given by two different eminent persons on software engineering. But as such, if you look at, as I've said already, software is not just by writing programs. So if I say programs alone make up software, it is a wrong intention, and that is one of the myth on software. So software is more than programs. When I define software, it is program plus documentation plus operating procedure. You need to understand what components will be involved on program, what are the set of components that will be involved in documentation and on operating procedures. When you talk about program, programs are nothing but both source code and object code, as you already know. When you come to specific documentation, documentation plays a major role on development of software engineering. When you are about to get a product, without manuals, you will not enter into a satisfactory product. So on development of a product, I'll prepare a satisfactory manual on side by it. So while preparing the documentation, I'll have four different terms. One is analysis and specification, design, implementation, and testing. As Bayer has said, the definition for software engineering, sound engineering principles. So now with documentation, we talk about all the four principles. The principles which we follow it on software engineering is analysis and specification, design, implementation, and testing. So software engineering can in turn be called as an ADCT principle: analysis, design, coding, and testing principle. So what is to be documented within analysis specifically? With analysis, we need to talk about formal specification. We will draw a context diagram where we give the entire context. Say for example, if you go for a result management system, particularly student result management system, if I am going to build a software for it, the different inputs required for building up student result management system and what possible set of output which I will extract out of the system, which I will represent clearly on the context diagram. As a third stage, I will draw a data flow diagram, some aspects on the student result management system which is given as input requires some database. So how the exact flow is being carried out will be explained clearly on data flow diagram. So these first three level of specification will be mentioned with your analysis and specification model. Then we will go for the design principle. Within design, we will look at flow charts and entity relationship diagram as having explained in DBMS. So as you know, flow charts are just to give a basic understanding of how exactly the system is to be designed. So we have various representations which is to be given for flow charts that we will represent, and we will extract the attributes which is required for each and every entity, based on which we will go for an architecture which is to be built specifically for a domain specific system. So that we will look at in the design. The third aspect of it, we look at implementation. As I have already said, the program involves source code and object code. So source code listing is to be listed, and cross reference listing is also required. With cross reference listing, we will look at some part of the coding in the header files. Maybe programming is not basically done with void main. Before to that, we will include some of the header files, say stdio.h, conio.h, which are the header files which is required to include some of the integers and mathematical functions, input output functions. So some programming which has already been done are to be included as the top of my program. So those things are listed under implementation scenario. Finally, when we look at testing, we need to have test data and test results. Say for example, if I have done a programming, I ask you to write a program to compute a number between 0 and 100. If it is a simple program, maybe you might be taking only 10 lines, a maximum of 10 lines to do this particular programming. So for this program, how much of testing is involved? No, if you have an answer of only one test data, it's a wrong intention. Say, you have to understand the scenario of writing a program to find whether the given number is between 0 and 100. For this, abruptly I will write 5 test cases. One on the boundaries, that is the boundary which I have mentioned to you is 0 and 100, and one within the limit. So that much you are quite comfortable with. So on the boundaries, if I am not quite clear about the boundary, I will check for 2 values on the boundary. So that means I will check with 0 and 1 on the left extreme of my boundary. On the other end extreme, I will check for 99 and 100 and some intermediary value for your satisfaction. Example, you take up a value of 50. So at most you will give 5 test cases for this simple programming. So for writing up 10 lines of program, it is better you would have done a testing with at least 5 test cases. So these 5 test cases are said to be test data, and the appropriate result which is generated out of it is called test result. Now we will go for the third concept on definition of a software. Now you can better recall the first two terms on software. One is on the program, which is nothing but the normal coding and the object code, the source code and the object code. With documentation is an important aspect. As I have said, we need documentation on analysis, design, implementation and testing. Now we are looking at the third aspect of software, which is operating procedure. It consists of instructions to set up and use software system, and it further gives instructions on how to react to system failure. In case of failure, how exactly the system should interact with the software so as to rectify with the failure have been explained in the operating procedure. So software entitles three different entities. One is a set of programs being written, documentation carried out, and the operating procedure done for it. So these three components involve the definition of software. Further, if you are going for engineering explanation, we have adopted certain principles, as I have said, ADCT principles, analysis, design, coding and testing principles, which are to be incorporated. That makes up a good software engineering. We will go for a short break. Before that, I will consolidate whatever I have said. Now that we have looked at what basically people think about the software and the myths on software, and I have gone for the definition of software in terms of literal definition and the technical definition, what Bayer and Shaw said, and I have explained to you what exactly you have to understand from the term software. Welcome back. Before the break, we have spoken something about the myths which people generally think on software, and we have defined what software engineering is, and we have talked about the various things on how to define a software. To proceed with the definition of a software, I will, as I've said, operating procedure. Operating procedure involves two different things. One is the user manual and the operational manual. When we talk about the user manual, I create a manual specifically with an intention of understanding the system overview, beginner's guide tutorial and a reference guide, which is to be given explicitly for the users. And with respect to administrators, I need to mention them with installation, procedure and system administration guide. So these two things are the major components involved in the operating procedure. Now we will talk about software process. How exactly, as we have defined software engineering to be manufacturing a software, we have to have a sequence of processes which is to be developed. So we will define what software process is. Software process is a way in which we produce the software. It differs from organization to organization. So the methodology totally varies between process. What is the need to use effective software development process? Developers can systematically use the best technical and managerial practices to successfully complete their projects. Why is it difficult to improve software process? We don't have enough time to develop, we don't have sufficient knowledge, so we lack knowledge, wrong motivations given, insufficient commitment are the basic factors underlying on it. Now we will look at the character, some of the characteristics of software. Software has a very special characteristic, that is, it does not wear out. As many times as you use a software, it is not going to vanish. So it's up to the CD which gets cracked or erased, it's not with the software which vanishes. So its behavior and nature is quite different than other products of human life. Further characteristics of software include, software does not wear out, as I've said already. Software is not manufactured, it is just a process which is to be adjusted. Reusability of components, software is flexible, as and when any changes that are to be made, that can be easily incorporated. Some of the applications of software include system software, real-time software, embedded software, business software, personal computer software, artificial intelligence software, web-based software, engineering and scientific software. To give you a small application of engineering and scientific software, you better can think of CAD/CAM softwares, like artificial intelligence software, some gaming applications which are to be included on artificial intelligence software. So these are some of the examples or some of the applications where software can be developed. Now we look at some of the terminologies that are quite often used in software. The first terminology which we will be looking at is deliverables. Different deliverables are generated using software development. Primarily, as I have explained to you already, a student result management system. With student result management system, results are one of the aspects of the deliverable which I will be mainly concentrating on. But within results, I will be looking at report that are to be generated. Based on the report, I can analyze on the report, I can talk about the previous existing history and the marks code, I can talk about the CGPA. So those are different set of deliverables which I can obtain on the software. So for example, on the deliverables, source code, user manuals, operating procedures, etc. The second terminology is milestones. The milestones are the events that are to ascertain the status of the project. What has been achieved at this point of time? What has I derived at this point of time? So based on the time factor, whatever we have derived, those are to be called as milestones. Example, finalization of specification is a milestone. Completion of design documentation is another milestone. Likewise, we have different milestones. The third terminology is product. What is delivered to the customer is called as a product. What is at the end aspect, what is given to you is called as a product. So product is nothing but source code plus specification plus document plus manuals. So these four concepts totally involve the product. And one more terminology which is called process, which actually I have said manufacturing a particular product. So process is defined as, process is the way in which we produce the software. If you are going for manufacturing a particular product, as you all might know, collecting the raw materials until it is being given as a finalized product, we call it as, every stages we call it as a process. So that has been given here. Process is the way in which we produce the software. The same has been incorporated for software also. And we need to clearly distinguish between these three aspects: measure, metric and measurement. The first thing is a measure. A measure provides a quantitative indication of the extent, dimension, size, capacity, efficiency, productivity or reliability of some attributes of the software, of the product or process. Measurement is the act of evaluating the measure. A metric is the quantitative measure of degree to which the system, component or process possesses a given attribute. So metric is a major aspect which we talk it in software engineering. We look at the explanation of software metrics in detail as we go on with the software engineering lecture. The other terminology which we have to look at in the software engineering is module. Module are called as sub programs, where it is not just the program being partitioned into small sets, that is not the sub program, where we should have at least some amount of functionality that is to be involved on this particular software development. So a sub program which involves a certain set of functionality, we call it as a module. So this is said at different terms in different meanings. If you take for example a typical DBMS systems, where whatever programming we write, we call it as stored procedures or triggers, which is called as a module. When we go for ADA, we call it as package, and we go with any type of language programming, whatever we do with Java and things like that, we call it as a module. Now we are about to define software component, an independently deliverable piece of functionality providing access to its service through interfaces. So we need to create interfaces which acts between two different systems. Say for example, I use a front end tool Java and I use a back end. So I need to clearly give an interface between the front end and the back end application. So those are to be involved as a software component. Now we are going to look at the basic classification on the software products. Two different classification exist. One is generic software, the other one is customized software. There are two different types of software products exist. One, generic products. So the products that are developed for anonymous customers. I don't understand who my customers are. So I basically develop a product where I can change as per the requirement. For example, if you go for general retail shop applications, where that is to be generic, I don't understand for whom I'm developing the product. So for example, the operating system, compilers and word process, etc., are said specifically as generic software products. The second type of software products is called customized products, that are developed for particular customers. So here I know who my customers are and what kind of a product I am developing it for them. The specific product is designed and developed as per the customer requirements. 80% of the projects come out of this type are understood at this category. Now we need to ask a question of what is the role of management in the software development industry. The management of software development is heavily dependent on four factors. First, we'll talk about people. Software development is a people-centric activity. Hence, the success of a project is on shoulder of the people who are involved in the development of the project. The second is on the product, who gives actually the solution to the problem. And third one is on the process, the way in which I develop the software. And lastly, on the project, a proper planning is required to monitor the status of the product development and to control the complexity level. So at most we are concentrating on these four factors. It is like a circle. We concentrate on the project, people, product and process. So it revolves around, and all these four factors totally contribute to the development of software. To manage a successful project, we must understand what can go wrong and how to do it right. So based on these four perspectives, like people, project, product and process, we need to understand how a successful project has to be completed. Now we are going to look at what exactly we have discussed so far. So summary of this particular session. What we have looked at initially is the general myths on software, where we have looked at what people presume that softwares could be. The second aspect is the definition of software and software engineering, where we have said software is not just programs, it's program plus documentation plus the way in which it is being operated, so the operating procedure. So both combined, the three terms combined together becomes a software. And we have defined what software process is, the way in which we have developed the software, the mechanism which was actually involved in the development of software, we call it as software process. And we have listed out the different applications of software, in wherein we have said artificial intelligence software, application software, system software, web-based software, and things like that. And some of the terminologies which are used in software, some things like deliverables, milestones, measure, metric, measurement, which are the parameters that are used predominantly as we go with software engineering terms. And the last aspect is the role of management in software development. That means how exactly the project is involved in the software development, processes actually involved in the software development, people involved in the software development, how this combination can be brought forward in a complete, wholesome, finished product. That is the role of the management. Some questions for you. Now you have to define what exactly is software engineering. Yes, you have recalled right. Software engineering adopts to the basic software engineering principles, sound engineering principles like analysis, design, coding, and testing. But we have to define for what purpose. Ultimately, we need to define good quality product, economic and reliable, which works efficient on real time machines. So that's the key terms which are to be involved while defining the software engineering. The second question is software a product or a process? It was actually taken up as a process. The sequence of process makes a particular product. So that's how we come for a finished product. The third question is, what is software metric? How is it different from software measurement? As we have defined, a metric is a quantitative measure of the degree to which the system, component, or process possess a given attribute. This is how it has been exactly defined. Say for example, measure, we used to calculate, say for the area. All know that the area of a circle becomes pi r square. The value which we get is a measure. In what terms we have to define that area? Is it in square meter or square centimeter? Measurement value. And the definition, the entire component is called as the metric. How exactly pi r square has been derived? This is called a metric. So these are the three questions which we have to recall as a part of this session. Thank you.